Hey everybody, this is Ray Carsoul for EGM here at San Diego Comic-Con 2012, and I have the distinct pleasure of speaking with a living legend, Mr. Ed Boon. Ed, how you doing today, man?
I'm doing good. I'm really excited about the showing the game here for the first time.
Yeah, dude, Injustice looks phenomenal. You guys announced two more characters on the roster here, Cyborg and Nightwing, right?
That's right, yeah. Nightwing is my new favorite character in the game. Awesome fighting styles, you know, two collie sticks, and he puts them together and fights as a staff. He's super acrobatic, and I can't wait for people to play it.
Now, I'm sure, of course, being, you know, one of Batman's former disciples, he's much like Batman and being a gadget character, correct?
Yeah, he's a gadget character, but he plays completely different from Batman. I think a lot of people will draw associations with Batman and Nightwing, but they're completely different playing characters. It's great, though, that they're in the same kind of Batman family universe, and but they play so different, radically different.
Very cool. Now, Cyborg is an interesting character because he's a gadget character, but he's also kind of a powerhouse. How is it trying to balance him?
He's kind of like a power gadget character, I would almost describe him, because he has all these kind of contraptions that his arms can turn into. You know, it's more like machinery and whatnot. But at his base, it's power. It's total, you know, kind of crazy over-the-top big moves and stuff like that. So I definitely would put him in the category of power character.
Very cool. We're also seeing the Fortress of Solitude level here. Of course, the iconic Superman, his home down in, you know, the Antarctica, buried under the ice.
Sure.
You know, how was it to design that level and to make it, you know, as expansive as it is and really kind of explore that for fans? Because a lot of times we only see little bits and pieces of it.
Yeah, everybody kind of associates the Fortress of Solitude with, like, you know, just kind of giant ice pillars and whatnot. So we really wanted to kind of give it a twist. On the upstairs, there's like this kind of portal to the Phantom Zone, and that's part of, you know, how you enter back when you go through a transition. And then on the downstairs, it's kind of like a collection of alien creatures. And, you know, it's kind of like Superman, where he's kind of almost imprisoning them, you know, from causing any more damage and whatnot. So it's a very new, more kind of contemporary take at that classic, you know, environment that everybody knows.
And how has it been to bring a lot of these characters' environments, they're 60, 70, 80 years old, and really kind of try and contemporize them for a modern audience?
That was one of the funnest things about it, is, you know, a lot of these characters, you know, in the past have been represented with just kind of like tights, you know, just kind of, you know, basically skin tight costume with, you know, some kind of a logo on it. And we really wanted to add more dimension to it. So we changed a lot of like the details to like armor, or some other kind of, you know, more stitching and that more nuance that people don't normally associate with these characters. So we're really happy about how these kind of really more three-dimensional representation of these characters is.
And how was DC when you said that's how you kind of wanted to bring these guys to life?
They were as open to the idea as we could. You know, they had just kind of relaunched the New 52. And that had some, you know, pretty radical changes, and so we added things to things that are just as radical, and so they love this kind of more contemporary look to the characters.
So would you say this is more based in the New 52, or is it more based in any particular era?
It's really based in the Netherrealm version. You know, we always think of the DC characters as, you know, traditionally we've seen, like, you know, the comic books, the animated series, the various movies, the New 52 and whatnot. So this is really like yet our kind of new niche into representing them. If anything, I would say it's probably a combination of the New 52 and the movie representation, but it's really a Netherrealm unique version of it.
Very cool. Now, of course, you mentioned the Fortress of Solitude, and there's also the Batcave we're seeing here. Do any of these guys, they have a little home field advantage if they should play on their own arena?
Yes. You know, that's part of the decision that we make in creating the interactive objects is, you know, a Superman arena might have some objects that power characters use more, like Superman, and a Batman arena might be more kind of gadget friendly, so to speak. So it's a great mix between the two, because just within the gadget characters of families, there is a variety within that too. So it's a really, the mixture is what I'm so excited about.
Very cool. Well, I guess last question, what systems and when can we finally get to play a full version?
Right now, we're giving, I'm embarrassed to say that we're giving a one-year window of saying it's coming out sometime in 2013. Obviously, over the next few months, we're going to be giving more detail on it, but I can tell you it's not December 31st. And then it's going to come out for the PlayStation 3, Xbox 360, and the Nintendo Wii U.